This week's edition of Church Media Design TV is sponsored by dansinkandtoner.com. Yes, you heard it here, ink and toner, and lots more. Welcome to another edition of Church Media Design TV, tips, tricks, and how-to for you, the church media designer. I'm your host, Brad Zimmerman, and with me, as always, it's the three wisest men I know in plastic form, because they're the only three or four men I know in plastic form. They're the three wise men of Jesus. And we have Little Whitey, the miniature version of me. We have Colonel Sanders, the King of Chicken, Dwight Schrute, the King of the Office, and Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord Most High. Well, this show is all about helping you guys utilize and use media in the church. And you don't have to be a church media designer. You could be a youth pastor, a children's worker, a volunteer, whatever it may be. But we want to be here to be a resource to you. So this week, we're going to give you a whole ton of free images because, well, they really, really help. So we're going to be talking about that. We're going to give you guys some great inspiration. We're going to be going to give you even more freebies. And there's just so much to do that I'm kind of losing my way in my speech. So, if the three wise men and Jesus are ready, let's get into it. Well, here's something old and something news. Yes, it's our cheesy play on words for a new segment, and we're going to cover a few different lengths of some things that I think you guys would find interesting, and hopefully they'll be useful to you. Now, something old this week is a children's book, Where the Wild Things Are, that's being turned into something new, Where the Wild Things Are, the movie. And so I don't even think it has the movie in the title. Hopefully it doesn't, because that would be really cheesy. But the trailer's on QuickTime's website, so we're going to show it to you now.
I didn't want to wake you up, but I really want to show you something.
Well, that was something old that's going to be awesome, but this is our something new, and our something new is Internet Explorer 8 is out. Now, this is an exciting news because we all know that Internet Explorer is terrible. Go download Firefox today. But we do have to deal with Internet Explorer. So Internet Explorer 8 is out, and our friend, well, he's not really my friend, but great blog, DavidWalsh.name, the David Walsh blog. He talks about PHP, CSS, MooTools, jQuery, and a lot of other things. He posted a hack that you can actually make IE8 emulate IE7 automatically for you. One line of code does it for you. So if there's a problem with how your web page is rendering out, you can throw in this one line of code. Everything's taken care of. Now, he encourages you, and I would too, to not use this as a crutch. Try to make your way around it, but download, make sure you have IE8 to at least test with. I think there's like a website for stats. I'll post it below right here that you can find out how many people are using all the different browsers and all of that kind of stuff. So IE8 is out, but you can hack around it. Our last bit of news, we talked about it last week, that MediaShout 4 is out, and I have actually gotten my copy. Here it is, MediaShout 4. We're going to be doing a review on the show in a couple weeks. So if you guys want to submit any questions or anything you want to know about MediaShout 4, I would love to cover those. So let me know about that. Also, the only other news that has to do with the show... My headphones just fell below me. Any other news that you need to know about the show is that we're coming out with a newsletter. And our newsletter, our first issue of the newsletter is either coming out right now or has already come out. And you can subscribe to it at ChurchMediaDesign.tv/subscribe. So if you just head over there, it'll forward you wherever you need to be forwarded to. But you can go there, subscribe for the newsletter. You're going to get extra freebies and a whole lot more. So make sure you guys sign up for that. So that's a little something old and something news. Well, this week I wanted to give you guys a whole bunch of resources because a while back I got a question from a viewer and he was kind of expounding upon this series we actually did almost a year ago. We did it on how to create announcement slides and what makes a good announcement slide. And one thing that I just reiterated with him and I want to reiterate with you guys is that the thing that makes your graphics look great is what you start with, what your source material is, where you're coming from. Because if you're starting with bad video, you're going to end up with worse video. If you start out with great quality, most likely you're going to end up with a lot better quality product. And one of the ways you need to do that is by having great source images. So this week we're going to provide you with a whole bunch of image websites. Now, these websites come with a disclaimer. Now, this disclaimer is, when working in our industry and working at a church and you're searching for images, you are going to inevitably come across content you probably shouldn't be looking at. And that is because a lot of these websites have great stock photography. Now, if that stock photography is of a lawn or a scantily clad woman, it's all there. And so I really want to warn you guys and give you the disclaimer, you need to be careful. I'll just give you one quick link to Canine Web Protection. And this is a free web filter that you can use. I think it works on both Mac and PC. I really want to encourage you guys to check that out because I know a lot of people struggle with it, and I really want to make sure you guys are taking care of yourselves as you're searching for this, because a lot of these sites have great things, great images, and we're going to show you them, but sites especially like Flickr and some of these other sites have issues that there is everything on the site, so you just need to be careful. So let's get started. I'm going to try to go fast through all of these. The first one is Free Photos Bank. Now, Free Photos Bank is like a lot of these. They have a great directory of a lot of different photography, a lot of quality stuff. Another one here, this is one that comes because of the disclaimer, Every Stock Photo. So you're going to find everything. You can search here, and this actually searches, let's see if it says here in the About section. It searches... No, it doesn't say. But when you do a search, like let's search for cross. That should be a pretty safe search for us to do. You can see that it's searching Flickr. It's searching the Stock Exchange. It's searching a lot of different sites. And you can do advanced search, and you can tell it where the source is, all that kind of stuff, minimum height and shape. Really, really cool. So that one's everystockphoto.com. Next up is freephoto.com, and that's F-O-T-O.com. And you can just search through here. They have stuff done by region where it was taken, which is really cool. They got some quality stuff here. Morg File, which is one of my favorites, has been one of my favorites for a long time. Morg File has some great photography. They're always second to this next site, which is the Stock Exchange, sxc.hu. I use this site all the time. This is probably the first place that I go when I'm searching for images, but it's the first place a lot of other people go as well. So if you want to make your photos look different, you want to have better, different source material, I would check out some of these other sites. But Morgfile is a place that I always go second to Stock Exchange. Next is freerangestock.com, and they have a lot of great photography in here. And yeah, it's a lot of different great stock stuff you can get at Free Range. Then we got Design Packs, which they have a lot of different collections for web designers. So you can go to their image catalog, and they have money and wood, and it's a lot more textures and that kind of thing. But next is StockVault.net, and StockVault.net has, again, great photos. What did they say? They have 12,816 free stock photos on there, as well as they have free tutorials and templates and some other different things that you guys can check out. So they got a lot of great stuff on there. Next is 9x13.de. Now, this site is in a different language, but it's got great photography. So they could be swearing at us the whole time, but I have no clue. But they have great photos. They're all taken by different regions. So if you want something from England or Egypt or Holland, you can find some really cool stuff, as well as it's done by colors and types. So again, this is a great site, and it comes from out of the country. So usually the photography has a little different flavor when it's coming from international. Next, we're going to start venturing into the world of textures as well as photography. Now, this is fromoldbooks.org, and these are classic books that have been scanned in, and you can get everything from the flourishes in the corners to old paintings and photos of Jesus to all sorts of stuff. So this is a really cool site if you're looking to have a more old Renaissance looking feel to stuff. So check out fromoldbooks.org. They got some different things there. And we're going to skip down a little ways and continue with textures, and we're going to go to the Texture Archive. Now, Zach Fonville, who's providing the backgrounds for this week's, or the freebies for this week's episode, as well as probably the background that's behind me right now, a lot of his backgrounds have a very textured feel, and it's because, well, he uses textures when he's making them. And so these next set of sites have a lot of different textures, and you can use textures a lot of times with 3D models to make a model feel more realistic, or you use them with photographs or your design to give them more of a real feel. So this one's a Texture Archive, and they have stuff done as doors, garage doors. You can talk about walls, walkways, patterns, the whole nine yards. Great site, lots of good images. Next up is CG Textures, which is computergraphicstextures.com. And these are meant a little bit more for 3D modeling, but again, you can use these for whatever you want. So check out this site. Again, a great directory. Everything's laid out. So if you're looking for landscape, you're looking for some signs, the whole nine yards, you can find them all there. They got a nice little previewer here, which I really enjoy on some of these sites. They do a good job of previewing things well. So next is imageafter.com. Imageafter is a great website. All of these sites are great. I probably should just stop saying that right now. But there's a lot of different things on here. I've been using this site for a long time. They got some really nice photos on here. Next is textureking.com, and Texture King, again, is all textures. It's got great categories. We can click on metals here, and we can see a lot of different corroded metals, and I'll show you how to use these in After Effects in upcoming episode on actually how to do text dissolves using a texture, which turns out really nice. Lost and Taken. Lost and Taken is a great website. You can go to their gallery, and it actually takes you over to Flickr. But man, they got some really nice stuff here. They have old book covers, and you can search through here and find some really, really nice stuff. So you can make, you know, this is the Missouri Appeals Reports, Volume 39. But really cool looking book designs that you can use in your photography. So Lost and Taken. He also has a blog that has a lot of different things on there, so you can subscribe to that. Then we have defcon-x.de, which again is another random site, but it's got a lot of great stuff. One thing I'll say that I should have said at the top is I weeded out a lot of sites. I weeded out a lot of sites that really weren't that good. These are some of the best as far as image sites go that you can find really good quality at. I didn't go to free random junkyphotos.com because I really wanted to make sure you guys had great quality. So DefCon X is another great site. Then we have highresolutiontextures.com, and like the name says, it's a bunch of high resolution textures. So you can find those there. They have a blog as well with a lot of different things. Then last but not least, well, this isn't last. Our last texture site is seamlesstextures.net. And Seamless Textures has a lot of great different seamless textures. Again, is done in categories, so you can easily find what type of photo you're looking for. Now our last site is Flickr. Now Flickr is an awesome resource. Again, comes with that warning from before that this is also a site where you're going to find stuff maybe you weren't looking for and didn't want to find. But you can find some amazing things on Flickr. This is a whole archive of USSR posters, propaganda posters from the USSR. Really, really cool stuff. Not because of the propaganda, but just the style of it is just really neat, and it's just really cool seeing this propaganda style has just such a cool feel to it. So those are some really cool ones. This one's a guy's photo stream of posters around Amsterdam. And this is kind of cool because you can actually use some of these posters and stripped out the text and reuse them for a video that I made. And so there's just pages upon pages of different like concert posters. And then here is like some vintage logos that were scanned out of this book, and just has some really cool old vintage logos that you can take a look at and get some inspiration for your logo design from. These were all taken from the book World of Logo Types. So one thing to be careful about with Flickr is a lot of times you got to figure out, do you have the rights to use this? All those other sites, for sure you have the rights to use those. Some of them say you need to credit the author, you need to tell somebody, that kind of stuff. But this site, Flickr especially, you need to make sure you have the right rights to it. The last place that I want to take you to on Flickr is the Church Marketing Sucks group. We talked about this on a recent episode. Let me just try find this. Where is groups? Let's go. Church Marketing Sucks Lab Beta. Now this is a awesome group. You can post your graphics, you can go into their discussion boards, and it's an awesome tight-knit group of people that you can get feedback from your graphics on, as well as it's a really great place actually to go search for stuff, not to use, but just to check out. So we were doing a Jonah series, and I was like, man, I wonder what other people have done for a Jonah series. So I typed in Jonah, and I pulled up a bunch of different Jonah graphics. And so I kind of could see what was out there or what had been there. Oh, this is interesting. Whale tails. And they have like this crazy huge whale inside a swimming pool. Pretty cool graphic. So it's a really good place to go like get yourself started on the path of inspiration. So Flickr is a great site. All of these places I want to encourage you guys to check out. Great sites. Get yourself some quality photography to start your graphics from. I really wanted just to let you guys know about this so that you guys can have more tools to create your stuff from. So next we're going to hit you guys with some great inspiration. Well, this week I got some great inspiration for you, and instead of showing you a video like the Comcast one, which is really fun to watch, but we can't make it. We probably don't have the tools to do it, nor the experience, nor the time/team, because these are done by huge teams of people and not just one guy in an office. I thought I'd show you, well, that same type of video, but how they did it. And this is the mainframe rebrand of Nickelodeon. And behind me, you're seeing some of the spots that they did. But what we'll show you after this is actually how they went about making it. Now, it's not a crazy step-by-step, but it kind of breaks down and gives you a bit of a feel of what it really takes to make something that turns out like this. It shows you the coloring and the highlighting and when they do color grading and how that affects the look. And it really gives you a better feel of what it takes to make something like this. So check out this breakdown of the mainframe rebrand of Nickelodeon. This week we got another freebie. This is a 30 pack of still images for you to use as worship backgrounds, or you could even use it for announcement slides or the background for a series graphic. These were provided by Zach Fonville. We interviewed him actually today, aired a little while ago on our live show, which was our last live show for a month or so, but it was a great time talking to him about what he does and how he does it. And these are really quality backgrounds. You're checking them out behind me, and I really want to encourage you guys to download them, use them in your church, save yourself some time because you don't have to create everything. So head over to ChurchMediaDesign.tv, download those. Also, you can check out Zach's site, which is ZachFonville.com. His nickname is Red Ferris Wheel. You can also find his Flickr stream at flickr.com/photo/RedFerrisWheel. So those are a few ways to stay in touch with him and find these images. He's provided the backgrounds for the last 4 weeks, so go back, download them from all of the different show notes over the last 4 weeks, and add, what is it, 120 backgrounds to your arsenal. So some great stuff. Thanks, Zach, and get yourself some freebies. Well, we wanted to say thank you to our sponsor of dansinkandtoner.com. Ink and toner and a whole lot more. Now, you've heard me week in and week out talking about Dan's Ink and Toner, and I want to continue to encourage you guys to sign up for Dan's Ink and Toner because it's going to save you money. There's no 2 cents about it. He will save you money. I highly doubt. I actually heard from a viewer that they were using a compatible cartridge, which should be cheaper than name brand, cheaper than buying from Staples. They were using a compatible cartridge for their printer. They called up Dan. They're actually getting name brand of the cartridge with a higher yield, and it's saving them money. Okay. So they're saving money by going the name brand way. So you don't even have to buy off brand, and you can still save money. So you can save money on ink and toner, plus you can also sign up for a leasing program, whole lot more. All you do is go over to the website, click here to sign up for the store. It'll send him your information. Type in Church Media Design into the promo code area, and That'll let Dan know who sent you, which helps us out a lot. And so let Dan know that you sent you, or that we sent you, and you'll get a 3-month risk-free trial of the wholesale program where you get ink and toner at wholesale costs, next day delivered whenever you need it. So it's a great program. Check it out. If you want to know more information about the wholesale program, you can click on wholesale, view it all there. But most off, I mean, there's a phone number in the bottom corner. Give Dan a call, send him an email. He'll tell you everything you need to know and figure out what's right for your church. And I really recommend the service. We use it here at our church. I have friends that use it and no one's disappointed. So I really want to encourage you guys to check that out. So check out dansinkandtoner.com. Well, thanks for tuning in to another edition of Church Media Design TV. So glad you guys could be here, and hopefully we've overloaded you guys with more images than you could ever comprehend getting, and all for free. So now you don't need to turn to stock image sites that actually cost money, because now you have a whole lot of resources. I think there's like 20 some sites that I listed off that you can search through, and hopefully by the end of it all, you'll find what you need or change your design and use something for free, because why spend money when you don't need to? That's kind of the lesson on this show. You know, as much as it's about church media, it's about not spending money we don't need to, because I would much rather spend money on the things that I need to spend money on. All that aside, I really want to encourage you guys to become part of the community. Send me an email, post something on the website, sign up for the newsletter. You can go to churchmediadesign.tv/subscribe. You can email me, brad@churchmediadesign.tv. Hit me up on Twitter. It's twitter.com/CMDTV. Or in today's case, Willis is here helping tape. And it's twitter.com/trellis3000 because he's not from this decade. He's from the year 3000. I don't know how it happened, but he's got some crazy stories. So you can check out Trellis there. And you can check out all of the links and all of the stuff on the show notes on the website. Get your freebie there and just stay in touch. Become part of the community. Like I said before, we're taking a break from our live shows for a little while so I can get the new website done, which should be great. So thank you guys so much for tuning in. I don't think I've forgotten anything. So as for me and the three wise men and Jesus, we're saying see you later. Bum, 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 bum. Here's the time for the final question. That didn't even sound right. Girls, just gotta have fun.
It's your party, Brad. That's what I'll say.
Okay, yeah, it is my party. And I will cry if I want to. Or I'll go like this. Ha ha! Well, this week's free. What?